Introduce yourself from the left.
I am Korubi Bhattacharji.
Joyti Roy.
Abhishek Dash.
Marshmi Oberoi.
Sharmishta Ghosh.
Simi Shaha.
Moshumi Sinha.
Good morning.
and I love your attire. Thank you so much. But please stay on the stage. We have something for you. Yes.
Some women were already asking, where are our chocolates? So that's what they're getting right now. We don't miss anything.
Great. So after this lovely song, the final performance of the evening is Patriotic Medley by the ladies of Hoi Choi community. So I would like to call upon Snigdha, Shubhra and Panchali. Thank you.
Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh,
Thank you so much. Let's hear one more round of applause for the last event of the evening. So now, before we close the evening, I am here to speak about Hoichoi and our next event, Durga Puja, as I promised earlier. Talking about Hoichoi, many of you who are non-Bengalis wouldn't even know what the name means. So starting from there, Hoichoi means Hullabaloo in English or Hallam Gulla in Hindi. Hoichoi is an organization, a non-profit organization that was started 3 years back to spawn the magical thread of Bengali culture in the Netherlands. It started with a 100-member team, and within these 3 years, thanks to the tremendous support, love and appreciation that we have received, we have grown to a 1,000-plus team in 3 years of time. Thank you so much. Yeah, as you already understand, it was a difficult achievement to make, but it was never possible without all your love, support and enthusiasm. Now, Hoichoi doesn't have the vision of only staying a Bengali community. We have a pan-Indian outlook. That's why we call the United States of India. We always encourage all works and all fields of people to come and assimilate with our endeavors. Now, coming to what we exactly do, you know, as we grew, we started from 100 people. We initially started 3 years back with cultural events like Bijoya Shammiloni. It's a cultural event held after the Durga Puja every year in Bengali culture. So we started with that. But as we grew from 100 to 1000, as Spider-Man rightly says, with great power comes great responsibilities. So we thought we'll pick up the responsibility of giving our best back to the society. So we tied up with Red Cross to help the homeless for distributing clothes to the homeless in the Netherlands. We have recently tied up with a non-profit organization based in India called Treasures of Innocence, who are based on providing education to not-so-privileged children. So we are supporting them financially, and we are also organizing cultural exchange programs. We also have been tying up with several academic institutions like the Gifted Minds International School, the first international school in Hoofddorp, for organizing educational sessions for the children and also their parents for shaping their future career path. Apart from that, we have been recently invited in the Honorable Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee of West Bengal's business convention, where based on Mamata Banerjee's request and the request of the entire Bengali and Indian diaspora at large, we organized a face-to-face interaction session with Mamata Banerjee with the entire Indian diaspora in the Netherlands. We also work very closely with the embassy, as all the other groups present today, to organize a face-to-face interaction session with the Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, when he was there last month and in the Netherlands. So that's about what we do. Coming quickly to Durga Puja. Many of you might already know what Durga Puja is about. If you do not know, just a quick thing. Goddess Durga is the embodiment of Shakti, the divine feminine power. Hinduism is one of those religions in the world, my friends, that still worships from the start of being a pagan religion. The nature worshippers, we still worship the divine feminine. And as legend has it, that Goddess Durga emerged as the combined power of the Holy Trinity of the Hindus, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. And she vanquished the demon Mahishasur, who had the boon that he couldn't be defeated by any god or any human. So that's why Durga came in power. So now, as we believe, as Shakti, Durga resides in every particle of the universe, right from its existence to its annihilation. And Goddess Durga is celebrated in great fervor all over India in form of Navratri, 9 nights, where in every night we worship one form of Shakti, one form of Goddess. And in Bengal, the last 3 days of this event, the 8th, 9th and 10th day, 9th being Navratri and 10th being Dasera, where we also celebrate Lord Rama's victory over Ravana, we celebrate these 3 days. You know, when we talk about Durga Puja celebration and the creating the picture in your mind about what is Durga Puja celebration in Calcutta, let's quickly take up a trivia. Netherlands is a country where the population density is 400 people per square kilometer. And Kolkata is a city where the population density is 26,000 people per square kilometer. That's the difference. And all of these guys are on the streets on those 3 days. we are trying to exactly recreate the same nostalgia, the same situation, and the same ambience.